Good morning, students. I am Vikram Singh Rathod, Assistant Professor, Center for E-Governance, Jaipur. Today I am presenting the functions in Python. First of all, we introduce about the functions. Remember, we earlier talked about working in script mode in chapter 1 of our Python of this unit to retain our work for future uses. For working in script mode, we need to write a function in Python and save it in the file having .py extension. A function is a named sequence of statements that perform a computation. It contains line of codes that are executed sequentially from top to the bottom by Python interpreter. They are the most important building blocks for any software in Python. The Python functions can be categorized into three parts. Number one is called module, then second, built-in function, number third, user-defined function. First of all, we discuss about module functions. A module is a file containing Python identification such as functions and statements. Standard libraries of Python is extended as modules to a programmer. Definitions from the modules can be used within the code of a program. To use these modules in program, a programmer need to import the module. Once you import a module, you can refer or use it any of its function or variables in your code. There are many ways to import a module in your program. The one which you should know are: first of all, defining the function, we use import keyword. And another is from keyword. First, I am discussing with import keyword. It is a simple and most common way to use modules in our code. Its syntax is import, then module name 1, module name 2, and n modules will be called in a functions. For example, at the script, we use math module. To call a math module in our Python code, first we define import, then module name math. On execution of this statement, Python will search for the file math.py. Then second, create space where module definitions and variable will be created. Then execute the statement in the module. Now the definition of the module will become part of the code in which the module was imported. To use, to access, to invoke a function, you will specify the module name and name of the function separated by a dot. This format is also known as dot notation in Python. Here we define an example. At the script, we take a value variable is equal to math dot sqrt. In this example, the math module called a function sqrt and then put a argument 25. The example use square root function of module math to calculate square root of the value provided in the parenthesis and return the result which is inserted in the value. The expression variable written in parenthesis is known as argument or actual argument. It is common to say that the function take arguments and return the value, the result. This statement invokes the SQRT function. We have already seen many functions invoke statements such as type, int, etc. Then after I am discussing the from statement to use to get a specified function in the code instead of the complete module file. We know beforehand which functions we will be needing. Then we may use from. For module having large number of functions, it recommended to use for instead of import. Its syntax is such as from module name, then import, then function name, then another function name, etc. Here I give an example from math import SQRT. In this line of code, the from keyword is used and call a math module, then import its function SQRT. Here we define a value is equal to SQRT and put the argument as a 25. Here we are importing SQRT function only instead the complete math module. No SQRT function will be directly referenced to the these two statements are equal to previous example from module name import star will import everything from the file. It means the math function related functions are automatically called by import math or from math statement. Note, you normally put all import statement at the beginning of the Python file, but technically they can be anywhere in the program. Let us explore some more functions available in math module. Here we define a table that contains three parts or divided into three parts. First part is of the table is define the name of the function, and second is description, and third one is example. First we define here is cell function. It returns the smallest integer, not less than x, where x is a numeric expression. It returns the smallest integer, not less than x, where x is a numerical expression. And then explained here some examples related to cell function of the math module. Math dot cell, then put argument -45.17 and our result is -45.0. And then after two examples are also described here, and the output is also described here. You can use it in your program code. Then after floor function, it returns the largest integer not greater than x, where x is a numeric expression. Example, math dot floor, then put argument -45.17, it returns -46.0. And then after fabs function, it returns the absolute value of x, where x is a numeric value. Math dot fab -45.17, then the argument execute and the result is 45.17. Then after exponent functions, it return exponential of x, x is a numerical expression, math dot exp, then put the value and our result is something number that you can see on your slide. We can also log function from math module. It returns the natural logarithm of x for the x less than 0, where x is numerical expression. Math dot log, put the argument 100 comma 12 and output is showing on the slide. Then we can use the power function. The power function is used to define value of the x, y, where x is a, where x and y are the numerical expression. Then we can use as an example math dot pow, then put the x variable value as a 100 and y variable as a 2, and when the code is executed, the output is 10000. It is the power of 100 square, and then SQRT. SQRT is used for calculate the square root of a particular variable. We put the x argument as in our example math.sqrt 100 and the output is 10.0. Then after we use some trigonometry functions in our Python. Here we define a cos theta variable. It returns the cosine value of the x in the radians, where x is a numerical expression. And the example math dot cos, and then put 3, the cosine value of 3 is returned as a result. Then the sine theta, it is defined as sine, math dot sine, and put 3, and it calculates the sine value of 3. Then tan theta, it use a x variable as a numerical value, and in the example we define math dot tan and put variable 3. The output is calculated and the result is display on your slide, or you can also run on your Python for any value you put in the tan trigonometry function. Then we can use degree function also as a mathematical functions. It convert angle x from radian to degree, where x must be a numerical value. The example so here math dot degree 3, it calculate the degree of 3, 171.887338539. When you execute it in your Python environment, the result is shown such as described in the slide. Then after radian x, it converts the angle x from degree to radians, where x must be a numerical value. Math dot radian and put value 3. The output is shown in the slide when you executed the program. Some functions from random modules are also described here in our slide. A table is described about random module. First of all, we discuss random function. It returns the random float x, such as that x greater than equals to or x greater than 1, then we put at the cell script random dot random, then bracket, then it's show a output on when you executed the code. In the next example, rendInt function, it use two arguments such as a or b. It return a integer x between and b such as x less than x or x less than b. The random dot rendInt, it use a as 1 and b as 10, and the result is 5, shown in the slide or when you execute on the shell script in Python. Then after we discuss uniform function, it is also used two arguments a or b or any kind x, y or something you can want to define as an argument. It return a floating point number such as x, that x less than or equal to x or x less than equals to b. The example is shown here. At the cell script, you can write the script code random.uniform and put 5 as a argument and 10 as a b argument, and its result is shown in the slide or when you execute on the cell script at your Python environment. RandRange function is also defined here. Basically, it is use three steps, or the syntax of the random range is use three arguments such as start, stop or step. Here start is the value from the range starting number, or stop argument is define the end of the number where you want to stop the range, and step is used to define the difference between one number or the next number that is print in your result to execute when you rand range function using your Python. It return a random item from the given range. Here we define a random example at Python cell script. You can define a random dot rand range, then define 100 as a start and 1000 as stop and 150 is step, and you can execute it. It print a number of series from 100 to 1000. Thanks. If you like the video, you share our official channel CGJPR. Thanks.